Hello everybody, I'm back with another video. This time I'm looking at Cities Skylines, which comes out actually on Tuesday the 10th, here in about 5 days. So this is a city builder, much like the classic Sim City. I'm not super versed in this genre, but I do enjoy city building games when I get a chance to play them. And I actually played quite a bit of SimCity 2013. EA Maxis's last outing. It was good. I liked it. I know a lot of people, it's kind of a divisive topic. I liked it. I thought it was fun. It was relaxing and enjoyable to sort of lose a few hours into it at a time. So, but it wasn't a game so much. It was not challenging. It was just sort of going through the motions and sort of enjoying yourself like an interactive movie. I put a few hours into this so far. This is a little more demanding. You had to kind of plan ahead. You had to plan a city. And it turns out I'm not great at that. But I'm going to go ahead and pop in and talk a little bit about what I've experienced so far, kind of how it works, and we'll kind of go from there. So first I want to show off is the options, because there's a decent amount of them. I do like that you've got some gameplay stuff here. You can change key mapping. I'm a fan of being able to apply color corrections to change some of the coloring in the lighting of the map. Speaking of maps, there are several of them. They're quite large because you start with a 2x2 kilometer square to build within, but as you hit milestones of population, you're unlocking more and more area, or the potential, if you purchase more area, to expand your city's city limits. You can make maps. You can actually use Content Manager. Oops, sorry, not Content Manager. What is it? Is it Tools? Map Editor. You can edit and create your own maps. You can create assets. There's a Steam Workshop integration. I imagine it won't take long before there is a ridiculous amount of content from the very skilled folks who bring you all the other great Steam Workshop and non-Steam Workshop modding content with games like Civ and Age of Wonders and Skyrim and the like. So, all right, well, let's just get into the game. I've played a couple maps here so far, and I haven't really had the best luck. Luck isn't really the right word. I haven't done great, but I have done okay the last couple times. So I'm gonna try it. Record this here. You get some information here. You can do left-sided traffic. Kind of have some information about area for building, different resources that are abundance. Like there's not a lot of farming on this map, but there's a good amount of forestry and ore, for example. So let's grab something here, like how bright these are. A lot of green there. Kind of like the way this looks here too, though. A lot of beaches over there, sandy beaches, lagoon shore. Let's go with a high building area. Two rivers. There we go. All right. Let's just give this a shot here. This will be the good time to point out that this is an early-ish build of the game. I mean, it's gonna be done here in 5 days, so it's probably fairly finalized. But this you may see some weird bugs or some weird issues, and some of that is likely to be because it's not a finished build. So just so I've said it. All right, here we go. Here's what you see when you first start playing. Your days are starting to advance. So I'm going to pause it right here, and it's telling me to build a road, and that's what I'm going to do. All right. So to start with, you have this is all grayed out because I can't choose things like water and electricity even to build. Not until I met the certain criteria. In this case, for example, if I want to build this two-lane road, I need to have... Actually, I can build that almost immediately after I build this first road section. But if I want to build a two-lane road with grass, I need to hit a population of 1,400. So as you're hitting population milestones, you're unlocking more and more of the game. And here's the first square, and I will be able to unlock most of this whole map eventually. It can be filled up with my builds and my cities. All right, let's just get going here. First thing I wanted to point out, I really like how when you're building, a road, it gives you markers for the blocks, and also you see the light blue shading in the left and right side. That's the zonable area where your citizens will be able to build. So that's actually kind of a nice little touch. Before I dive in building roads, and I 70,000 seems like a lot, but I have been able to overspend early on and been forced to restart or get a bailout loan, which is embarrassing, so we're going to try and avoid that. I like how the water looks. You can zoom in real close, and it's very peaceful. I could just leave it on this for a couple hours. All right, so let's build the road, and I think what I'm going to do is, since I've got... I don't even know what direction this is flowing. This way, I guess. So that's good to know. I'm gonna have to pump the sewage somewhere, so, man, I'm gonna have to build really far down there to get to, a water source and sewage. Okay, so what we might do is come up and then go all the way down here. Okay, and then we're gonna build another road and do the same thing here, and let's build a curvy road for that one. Okay, there we go. A little bit of a bridge there. Nice. All right. That was like 16,000 right there. So, I need to kind of... I want to try and maximize some of my space here. Let's build like that. Far enough over, I don't think. Close. There we go. Alright, so we're going to zone. This area here will be zoned. You can paint the zone in a box. You can paint it with a small or a large paintbrush. You can just paint a fill like that. Let's get in the center here. Some commercial zone. Here we go. Yeah, probably could have just filled all that. Yeah. Okay, and then we're going to go with some residential zones right here. There we go. Okay, and you can see they're already starting to build. I'm starting to get some citizens moving in. Over here seems like a good place to try and put. We can put some wind down. How much does it cost to build a coal power plant? 19,000. How much does this cost? Wind turbines. Let's just build some wind turbines. And you can see the it automatically goes into an overlay that shows off the darker areas where the wind is the strongest. It would be kind of nice to have an island of wind turbines, but I don't have access to the build out there. So let's just put some wind up here. Try and get that sweet 8 right there. Let's try and get a second one. 8 might not be enough to... Okay, there we go. Now, you have to build power lines as well. So I need to put a power... my first power line needs to be within the blue radius here, and it needs to get connected over there. So what I might do is follow the road, since I can. There we go. There. And now I should be getting power over my citizens over here. And I need to do sewage, and they're going to need water as well. So let's put the water here. And I guess I can see the flow. It's not flowing very fast, but it is flowing that direction. So we will have the water be up here. And we'll have the sewage way down here. And we're going to draw pipes. Connecting the pipe to here, all the way to here, and then we're gonna have this guy go out to here, and we're gonna have this pipe come out to here, and kind of want to get my overlap going. There we go. There we go. And We're still missing a little bit of pipe. Here. Alright, now, everybody should have water, and everybody should have sewage, and we should have power. So, how are we doing? People seem happy. You got some overlays up here. You can look at the happiness overlay. You can use these charts here to see the residential happiness average. We can take a look at wind without having to bring up the wind turbines. Here's traffic. You can see we don't have a lot of traffic issues just yet. What we need to do actually next is we need to zone some industry because we do want businesses. And we're going to put those way down here away from people's homes and over here by the plumbing plants where there's noise already and everything. And we're going to let that stand. We're going to just advance time a little bit. And watch them build. It looks like they might be missing power. Now, I'll tell you why they're missing power. They're clumped all by themselves over here. So if I click on the power button, that will eventually overlap and touch this blue, which does have power. But in the interest of not angering my people, I am just going to provide them power immediately. There we go. Power is being applied. And those will go away. There we go. Because I can always bulldoze these later. These do have an upkeep cost, so you don't want to have them all over the place. In fact, this is by far the cleanest I've kept it. As you're unlocking population and making money, you're unlocking things like the economy panel. So we can take a look at this. You can actually reduce the budget on your power and water and a few other things. For example, power, we are producing. I don't know how to tell. I know we're producing 16 because I put down 2 8 megawatt towers and we're only using 4. So I could technically reduce my power consumption and save some money per week. But here's the problem with that. I've zoned quite a bit of residents and industry and commercial. That's going to eventually start filling up and it's going to start needing all that extra power and all the extra water. So I'm probably not going to save as much as the headache's going to be later. Plus, it looks like I'm actually making money now. People are happy. People are moving in. There's a little demand here. These little resident commercial and industry, they call it the RCI. They sort of fluctuate and tell you what the people want. It looks like we have a sewage issue, and that's not good. So we need to figure out why that is. So, I can see right away I need to get power down to my sewage. And that's going to be a little expensive. Again, we wanted to keep the sewage pretty far away, so that's just how it goes. Fortunately, I had enough money to bring power down to the sewage, and we ought to be okay here now, assuming I have enough power in general. Yeah, it was only an extra megawatt. Yeah, okay, we're good. And we should start seeing these sewages boost time up, drop away also. Returning people to happiness, productivity, and I'll start getting more people moved into the city, and we will begin growing and getting taxing going on. So, and you can, this is a full-on simulation. I mean, the traffic is modeled, people are modeled. Here, let's click on a dude. I want to click on this dude. Stephen White. I went to school with a guy named Stephen White. That's wild. You can change his name. He's an uneducated adult. He resides here. You can click on it. Okay. Well, you can't click on it when he's really fast. But you can click on this. It'll take you to his home. That's where he lives. You can find out where he works. He works at this general store. It's probably where he's heading right now. He's going to the convenience store. Oh, he's just going shopping. So, up to, I have 400 people in this little tiny village, basically. And the game is able to model up to 1 million. It sounds like. So that's quite impressive. I wonder how that's going to look when you're actually playing for hours and hours in the same map and just have a giant sprawl. So here we are. I've reached a population of 420. That's the very first milestone, and so I've unlocked the ability to adjust taxes. I can take out loans. I now have access to and will be required to use garbage, healthcare, and education, specifically elementary, medical, and landfill. So first thing I want to do, I got $35,000. Before this gets away from me too far, I need to put up a landfill somewhere. And I feel like with the $35,000 I got, I could probably move it pretty far away. I don't necessarily want it with my industry over here. So I might just move it a little bit further away. Okay, like that. We're going to build garbage. We're going to stick this guy way over here. I mean, yeah, the purple range is like the gross part. But that's good right there, I think. I don't think it needs electricity. Oh, it kind of does. Well, that's okay. We've got a little bit of, we can put that right there. All right, next up, let's build a medical clinic. We can probably unpause it. Medical clinic. We want to put this kind of in the heart of our population. So what we're going to do is we're going to put that guy probably like, well, we're going to grow here, and we're going to grow up here this way. So it's probably best to put it like right up here. There's nothing built right there yet. That makes people really happy because now there's a clinic. And the last thing we should probably do is get an elementary school going, because we do want to have a population that's educated. And we want to have that also in nearby. That improves land value and makes people happy. It's all around a good thing. So now, the early parts of the game, from what I've been able to see, is really just kind of easing you into managing the day-to-day of the city and planning your roads. You don't even have that many different types of roads, really. Soon I'll have to manage police and fire, public transportation, parks, different kinds of unique buildings that will unlock as I reach milestones. Here's a bit of a funny note about this game is this little Twitter guy here. There's been some people who really don't like him, and some people really like him a lot. You'll be able to turn him off in the full game. The version I have here, you can't yet. I actually kind of like him. He says some funny things. My only regret is that he repeats himself a couple times, which can be sort of frustrating and seems sort of silly. Alright, let's just take a look at the city here. That's half the fun of building a city, is watching it grow and thrive, right? And succeed. So, you know, this we should get some people to move in here. That'd be nice. What do we got here? Yeah. I love the way that everything looks. It's nice. Oh, see these guys here missing out on power. Again, it's because I got power going here, but I don't have power going to this little group. So we will, we'll just connect this right to here. There we go. And boom, now they have power. We already had water going there, so unlike SimCity 2013, water is definitely something we had to kind of handle. Water and electricity, you had to kind of take care of that stuff with running pipes and running power lines. We can probably get rid of this, I think, now. So let's bulldoze and get rid of these guys, because we don't need them anymore, and they're going to be something we want to eventually get the space back for. Oh, all right, look at that, a worthy villager. This is going pretty quick. Now I can adjust policies, I can draw districts, I can specialize in different types of industry. I have fire and police. I don't have any unique buildings. Unique buildings seem to become available when you reach certain specific conditions, like getting, having like a huge number of people healed from the hospital or something like that. I will look at a couple of them. Interestingly, what it seems like, once you unlock the building, it's available for any subsequent playthroughs. So you're kind of unlocking it as it's like an account reward. So we can do agriculture and forestry now. We can, these are some new policies we can manipulate in the city. Or by region, I think. Or by district. And we can now do police and firehouse. So let's, once again, let's just sort of take a look at some of these new options. Let's get rid of this guy. We don't need that anymore. If you look at power, these guys all became one big giant blue blob. So this power, they're freaking out originally, initially because I moved those power lines, but they're going to get power from this guy here. And we don't need to have all the extra upkeep. So we're going to speed things up to make sure I'm right. And, you know what? I'm starting to think the problem could be... Ah, it is. We're consuming 18 megawatts of electricity, so the problem is we are out of power. So I'm going to go ahead and plop down another power right here. And that's going to get rid of this guy, but I'm going to go ahead and fix that right away. And there we go. And now we should have plenty of power for now. I am going to need to take care of my power requirements soon. And we will. So, let's unpause it. That'll get the electricity back up. There we go. Alright. Next up, fire and police. Alright, so let's do a fire department. This is going to bring up the fire safety overlay. We have a high risk over here and a high risk over here. So, I guess we'll put it kind of in the middle and help no one. Nah, let's just put it over here. There we go. That makes people happy over there. It's 12,000. I can't really make another one. But I can put some police down. We'll put them up here. There we go. And I'm out of money for now there. Now let's paint some districts. This is kind of a neat idea because what you can do with districts is you can kind of have, let's say you wanted to have this be one district. And it gives itself a name, Underhill Heights. You can rename that. And you can actually click on it for information. This specific district has got this information, and you can set policies. Like I could say, in this one district, let's restrict water usage or power usage or enforce smoke detector distribution. In fact, because I put the fire department right here, let's draw another district over here. Okay. And this is Holly Square, which is, we can rename it. But let's go into policies and say, in this region, I want smoke detectors to be mandatory. We're gonna provide them, so it's gonna be a cost to us. I'm gonna drop down a little bit there. Not a lot. There's not a lot of population because this is actually a industrial area. So not a lot of people live here. No one lives here. So now we've got this policy set for just Holly Square. That should reduce their risk of fire without having had a second firehouse way over there, if I understand it correctly. So let's take a look at fire risk. Boom. And they're still pretty high risk, but hopefully that'll reduce as time goes by. And over here, well, especially right next to the fire department, not such a big deal. Alright. I'm noticing in my RCI that a lot of people want more places to live, and we have no reason not to expand a little bit. We won't go right next to there. I do want to build some more roads because we can squeeze in some more stuff here, I think. I don't want to build over that. Like that. And like that. And like that, okay. I don't want to. I'm making a little bit of money, so I can go. I don't have to worry about it too much. But let's just get some more here and here, and a little more commercial in the middle for people to go shopping. Okay, there we go. And that's how that looks right now. So. Seems like I'm doing a lot better this time. With anything else. Practice and planning make things easier. Now the next big hurdle of this size of city starts to encounter, and I've seen it every time so far. This is the third city I've been putting together. Educated workers become an issue, but I did put down an elementary school, and that's kind of all I can do for now. I'll get a high school, I think, here pretty soon when I hit 1,000 population. I think is the next milestone. There's a way to look at that, but I don't remember how to do it now. I'll look at it here in a bit, but for now, I want to actually build some more roads. Because I have yet more... money to spend, and I may as well spend it. Okay. Oh, I don't want to do the curve roads there. Okay. And one more. There we go. Hopefully the traffic isn't too bad over there. Let's again do something like this, something like this, and we will just paint in some of that. Okay, good. There we go. Get some more money, I'll expand out over here and maybe do some curved roads and some fun stuff. It's always a risk, though. I mean, yeah, you're going to get more money from taxes when you start expanding your city, and you kind of have to expand your city to get anywhere in the game. But, you know, you run the risk of running out of power, and we're getting low on power now. And water. Actually, water, we have plenty of water. Thanks to building a water pump, I suppose, right there. So, I can't afford, actually, any more of these guys. So, I'm going to have to hope I don't run out of power before I get the money to buy another one of those. I should prioritize it, though. And that's going to be $6,000. $6,000. Okay, so that's not too shabby. And let's see here. Let's go back here. I'm going to show you something else. See how I move the cursor to... I can expand this guy. I can actually kind of curve it around so it's not quite so big or whatever. If I were to build next to it, I could actually sort of butt up and create an additional district right over here. I don't really want to do that, but I can do it, and that's how you do that. It's kind of it's a real cool system. Kind of interested in playing around with that some more. All right, Lake Valley. You can change the name of your city. We can call this Lufferville. And we're people don't really demand a lot right now. Everything seems like it's going fairly smoothly. I think we can just advance time and wait for our population to go up a little bit more, and then I let the money kind of roll in. Supervised smoke detectors, free of charge. I love this city. Oh, we are getting low on power over there, looks like. See how these people all kind of popped up? We knew it was going to happen, though. This isn't a huge surprise. I knew we were getting close, and I knew it was going to be a problem. So, in the next week, we'll speed things up. We should have enough money to buy another power over here. We'll pop it down over here, see if I can... We don't have to keep them all together. We can put them over here, actually. I mean, honestly, they don't make any pollution and just a little bit of noise, and it's not that big a deal, so I might just put them over there. Okay, perfect. I can actually afford one now. 3 megawatts? Okay, so the problem would be that you're getting, like, jack over there. So, here's 7. Here's 7. Can I get 8 out of there at all? Get 8 over here. Perfect. Perfect! They're pretty cool looking. Yeah, that's nice. That's real nice. We're getting some ground pollution over here. Hopefully that's just an abstraction and not actually purple ground. Alright, how are we doing on power now? These guys should be good. Alright, let's just resume speeding things along. What is this? Milestones. Oh, okay. What's next? Oh, 1300, okay. We just got there. alright, tiny town. We are now a tiny town. We can do decorations. I forgot to show you the unique buildings. We can ban pets to keep the slight reduces the garbage accumulation. Speaking of garbage, did we unlock garbage? Yeah, we did. Smoking ban, parks and recreation for parks and trees, and a high school. First thing I want to do is see... Oh, yeah, I can't afford a high school, so that's... What? I should have looked closer. How much was that going to cost? $24,000. Well, we're close. Let's look at these buildings. So you'll see there are multiple tabs. I can do level 2 buildings right now. That's what I can build. I can't even look at the other ones. But you also notice I don't have access to this stuff. And in order to unlock, like, let's say I want to unlock this Statue of Wealth. City has 500,000 money. Well, that's not going to happen anytime soon. But if it did happen, Like if I built this whole city up and I got really far into it, I could unlock a lot of these cool unique buildings, which would make subsequent playthroughs. Well, I don't know if they'd be easier because I'm not sure how powerful these buildings are, but it would give me access to some unique abilities and rewards that I wouldn't otherwise have. So I'm pretty early in my exploration of the game, but content-wise, feels like there's a lot going on. There's a lot of stuff to build and manage, and they aren't really holding your hand. So kind of nice. I do want to build this high school. The upkeep is 560, so that sucks. But I'm making 1700, and we need it. That's the thing. We do need it. So we're gonna put this monster. Let's put it right over here. Okay, that makes people happy. And I'm going to lose a little bit, but, you know, we'll get some people moved in. How are we on... Yeah, well, there's still some places people haven't moved in yet. How are we on power, I wonder? Oh, man, we're getting close again. Jeez. That's fine. We can build more wind turbines if we have to. What's this dry patch here? Oh, I like to speed things up and watch the building. It's kind of fun. The Florence residence. Just got to have people move in now. People seem pretty happy. Let's look at the happiness map. Well, we got one building, but there's no one living here. That's why it's unhappy. Everybody's happy. Everybody's really happy. It's good. How are we on housing levels? That's interesting. More taxes. We need some more resident or some more commercial. Looks like. Easy to fix. What we'll do is we will draw a little bit over here. I kind of want to build, have some more of this going on, just because it's revenue, and that'll drive up our desire for more residents too. Excuse me. Oh, there we go. I can finally put one of these guys down. 8's the maximum you can get. There's no real reason that I know of to not try and maximize if you can. Moving around. Okay, that should help a little bit. Here's the power map. Everyone's got power. That's good. Yep, that's good. Alright. I could probably make some more money if I reduced the smoke detector distribution. Let's take a look at that. So right now I have this smoke detector distribution on, and I could have a smoking ban as well, which increases health but slightly decreases happiness. Parks and Recreation would increase decoration budget by 20% and improve the land value around parks. And there's actually some nice parks you can build. I just can't afford most of them. But you can put down trees, and trees reduce noise. So you can kind of make, I can make these residents a little bit happier by probably lining up some trees here to keep the noise from the highway off their back porch. They model a lot of this stuff really well. Here, oh, look, noise pollution. This is real loud. Like, this is a kind of a loud city, some of it. So in theory, if I were to put down, and I guess I might as well do it for demonstration purposes. What did that look like? Well, not much I can do by this probably here, but I can probably try and alleviate some of this if I build some trees here. So let's just build a couple trees. Some variety there. Okay, and there we go. A little bit less noise shrinking a little bit there. So, you know, you can't spend all your money on trees, and I kind of want to build there eventually, so that's probably not going to be a thing. Let's see, I need more residents, so I'm going to have to start building up. And we're going to go like this. We're going to do some of this. Perfect. And we're going to... let's do this here. Burp. Oh, that's not what I wanted to do. You can right-click to undo, or to de-zone. Let's do this. There we go. And I kind of want... Because we can actually take the district tool, and we could make a separate district over there, but there's no reason to, I don't think, yet. I think if I haven't already, I'm going to eventually unlock... I did agriculture. So we can go and look at crime. That's not a big deal. Outside connections. Natural resources. Green is forest. We have a lot of forest. So if I were to buy, and I think I can actually go out here, and yeah, I can purchase this block for 5,000. Of course, I don't have that kind of money, but I could purchase that block, and then I would be able to build south of my city here a little bit. Well, this would just become my city, and I could actually build down here and build some forestry services down here. What else do we have besides forestry? Here's some agriculture. We could get some farming going up here a little bit. There's some oil right there. That would be a lot of money. And there's some ore over here and over here. So in my immediate vicinity, I don't have a lot of access to... I could build some forestry stuff right here, actually. So maybe that's something I could look into doing once I get some money and I could extend this road. Actually, I could probably do it right now. How does that work exactly? I think I need to create a district, a zone. So what I need to do is I need to look at basically anything from this power line north is forestable. So let's draw this, like that. Well, maybe not quite that high up. Okay, there we go. Underhill Heights. No, you can't be the same thing. Let's change this to Black Forest. I have Great Ham. All right. So now what I do is I go into the zoning tools, I pick forestry, and I click boom, and now any industry that I zone in there is going to end up being forestry zone. Like so. And I think what I want to do is I can go kind of up with the road a little bit, so I'm going to do that. And we're going to build... like that, and like that. Okay. Oh, sorry about that, guys. All right, and then we're going to zone this also as industry, and it's going to be forestry industry. So that's all that's how that works, I think. Yeah, kind of a neat system. You can do agriculture, mineral. There's like tourism, there's freight, there's boat, there's plane, there's all kinds of ways to move your goods and produce goods and export and keep track of all that stuff. What are you doing? This is a nice car. Sports car. Where's Charlie? Oh, look at that guy. He's in there. He's working. He's an uneducated worker with a sports car. Yeah, that makes sense. Alright. Looking pretty good here, I think. So I think what I'm going to do at this point, I'll speed things along because I kind of want to see what gets built over here. Forestry Friends Limited. Parks, planks for life. So the forestry will bring in a little more money than just regular industry would have, but it probably has some requirements I should have likely been paying attention to. Let's take a look at that real quick here. Farming. Slightly increased electricity consumption, so they gotta keep an eye on that. Slightly increased tax income and requires forest natural resource renewable. So we knew that was likely to be the case. All right. So all right. Well, I think that's probably going to be good for now. I would like to do some more videos with this once it's actually out. I just wanted to get this out there and show it to people. It comes out in 5 days. I'm not really allowed to speak about my my actual opinions on it, other than to say I'm going to play it quite a bit more while I get my head wrapped around it, I think. So thanks so much for watching, and if you have any questions or suggestions or any requests, please feel free to put them in the comments. Looks like I have a lot of work ahead of me here with these guys and their power. So on that note, I will bid you adieu. And thanks again for watching. Please like and subscribe my video and pass it along to your friends. Thanks again.